These ladies are hot. They're so very hot.
Ready?
Yes.
Hey guys, it's the J Sisters and we're back with another video. So,
tell them what the video is about to be about, Jess.
First of all, I know you guys missed us.
Period.
I know you missed us. It's been a while.
It's been a long time.
So, hope everyone's doing great. Hope everyone is staying safe and healthy, wearing the mask. Not going out to eat, being really healthy. Anyway, today what we're doing is I'm going first to the gas station because I have zero gas in this car. Secondly, oh, by the way, I got a car over quarantine, so there's that. So we're gonna go get some gas, then we're gonna go to Culver's, which is like this really—
It's Culver's? I thought it was Culver's.
Culver's, that place, a sea place. And
good.
It's like Steak and Shake, but
better.
Yeah,
real fresh. Yeah. Delicious.
Yeah,
10 out of 10.
Yeah.
Okay, so okay, bye. We got the food. Smile.
Okay. Hugging the box, is that weird? No.
Oh, look at this beauty. Oh, look at the bun.
I really just wanted the box. You know you still have to hold on to the tray.
I'm just gonna open it like this and then move this way. I can't even. Hello food.
Girl.
One ketchup packet on.
Jayla is
a ketchup fanatic.
Mm-hmm.
I put ketchup on
it. Like in Polynesian.
Mm-hmm. Of course. Mm. That is so good.
Oh my gosh. I haven't even been into my burger yet. Y'all, Jayla
loves food.
She was so excited when I said, hey, we're gonna go somewhere else. And she was like,
yeah, we're gonna go to Panda Express.
Yeah.
And then I was like, Culver's.
I said Culver's.
No, I can say Culver's.
I did.
Girl, hold on.
Gosh. This is so good.
This burger is so good.
Mmm.
It's good, isn't it? Mmm. It's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Take them before they get cold.
Mmm.
Life hack. Get a french fry on your burger. I got a french fry put in half on my burger. Right there. Then you just want to get a little bit of ketchup. Just a little bit.
Mm. I could not work there.
At Culver's?
Mm-hmm.
Two pack.
Too busy. Same thing with Chick-fil-A.
Mm-hmm.
I can never.
Chick-fil-A is busy.
It is not my pleasure.
What, Chick-fil-A? It's so good. ketchup mix burger. So good.
Why is this girl wearing Uggs?
I don't know.
In the middle of the summer.
I don't know. It's like 85 degrees if she's out here wearing Uggs.
82.
And she's pregnant.
Oh, yeah, she's pregnant. I don't look pregnant until I turn around, Chad.
Shut up.
And the worker's like, can you please leave me alone? She's looking at her like, please leave me alone.
Why is that in the back anyway? I'm doing online high school right now.
I'm doing online college.
And honestly, I'm not mad about that. Perfect. It's good. Easy, fun. Not, let me not say easy. Honestly, it's just like more laid back.
Yeah, honestly, if it means that, I mean, it's not perfect. I mean, there's a little issues here and there, but
sometimes the website crashes.
Yeah, but if it means if it means that I am not spreading my germs and no one's spreading their germs on me,
then we're good.
All I care about. I mean, yeah, they're mandating masks at my school, but if you mandate masks at the store, doesn't mean people are gonna actually wear them. I mean, they put them on, and it's like this. They wear like a chin strap, or put it on top of their head, so.
Cause they don't even care.
She's still standing outside. I know she's hot.
People are on the fries on that bite right there. What are you even talking about?
I don't know, but the girl is really trying to get into the building.
Just gonna say that. Are you good?
Now you ask me? No, I wasn't good. I had a brain freeze.
You're fine.
I thought I was about to pass out.
Me and Jazz have been listening to the Hamilton playlist soundtrack
every time we hop in the car. Or when we're cleaning the kitchen or anything. We watched Hamilton one time.
Once. We gotta watch it again though.
And
it's so good.
Now we know every song.
I love all the songs.
Especially
top three.
Satisfied.
Helpless and
Burn.
Top three. So if you haven't watched Hamilton or listened to all the playlists, whatever, do it.
Go do it.
After you watch our video. Yesterday for my high school, one of my high school classes, we had to make cookies, and I made homemade oatmeal cookies. No raisins. I hate raisins. And they were really good. Insert picture here.
Don't.
they were so good. Like, they were good. I was pretty proud of myself because I was expecting them to come out and be nasty. So a few broke.
A few? She made 9.
The recipe calls for 12. I only got 9 out of it. I don't know how.
And only 3 of them are not broken.
No, 4. I ate one that weren't broken, and there was 3 more that weren't. So 4 of them came out,
the majority,
not broken.
Half of your...
But they were really good.
More than half of your cookies were broken. I've never heard you say that you didn't like something that you made.
No, they were good. I actually need to grease the pan more. But yeah, so I'm pretty proud of myself for that. Oh, I thought...
You know what's crazy? As I'm looking around, like, we're by a bank, a Dunkin'. And Culver's. And there's like a couple little shops across the street.
Road, cars. Mountain behind.
Road, cars.
Standing out of the
trees,
hat on backwards.
Butterfly.
Tattoo. I want a teardrop tattoo right there.
Please, everyone, tell Jill that is a stupid idea. She hasn't killed anybody.
Who said I haven't killed anybody?
Who said you won't kill somebody?
Period. So, just for the future, I just want a teardrop right here. Like, no. It would be cool, like on my driver's license.
No, just have
like a sticker.
Flower sticker on your face. Anyway, that's what I was saying before I was rudely
interrupted. I'm gonna get food on my finger.
Yes,
you said you're full. Exactly.
I burped.
Okay, continue.
Now I deserve a teardrop.
No, I get a teardrop.
Wait, that's not even fair.
Okay, what are you gonna say?
Don't forget to run.
Where were you? Okay, I mean my last one.
What I was saying was that you wouldn't even like be able to tell that we're in the middle of a pandemic because there's so many people.
We've been in a pandemic for 6 months and people think this is
that like we're over. Back to normal.
Yeah, like we're not back to normal. Oh,
there's I just want a sense of normality,
girl.
It's not gonna be normal. We're in the middle of a pandemic, so no, Karen, you cannot go into the restaurant and eat your food.
This is far from over.
Even though the restaurants are open, because no one in the government cares about our health.
And then I read in the news crying, talking about, my mom's dead. Yeah, it's because she went to Culver'S.
I know a couple of people who I go to school with who didn't take this seriously at all. Why am I holding the steering wheel? Who didn't take this seriously at all. And then someone in their family got corona. Some of the people that got corona died from it. Mm-hmm. And now they want to wear a mask. Now they don't want to go out. Yes, you're spaced out, social distanced in the restaurant, but it's in the air. Someone sneezes, someone coughs, someone talks, someone breathes in the air. People within 14 feet of them have it as well.
Yep.
Anyone who's within the restaurant, because everyone who goes to the restaurant goes to the bathroom, you're gonna be in the bathroom with that person, not social distance. You're gonna walk past that person's booth or table, not social distance. You're using the silverware. Yeah.
Open the door.
You're opening the doors, because not everyone uses the paper towel to open the door. You're using the silverware that gets touched by multiple people. Cups. Yeah, some people put their gloves on to wrap the silverware, but I worked at a restaurant before. I know what happens when it's too busy and you don't got time to get gloves, or you got on gloves and you use the same gloves that you used to grab this and this and this and this, and now you're wrapping up silverware. So it just doesn't make sense to me. It kind of disappoints me to know that America is so stupid. You don't think this is real? A lady that came into the store yesterday that I work at was telling me that this is not real, and she's never
met anyone. And she gets it.
She's never met anyone who has corona. More people have died from the flu. Okay, yeah. But I know multiple people.
The flu was not a whole pandemic.
Yeah, I know multiple people who've had corona and people who've died from corona. And she's like, well, they probably had underlying conditions.
No, and even after you get coronavirus and you don't
you
die,
still get underlying
you still
conditions.
Get heart problems,
kidney,
and a lot of
lungs,
stuff.
Brain. We feel like it's meant to kill us.
Like, we can't even go to school if we don't get a vaccine shot, but we can go to school during a whole pandemic.
Yeah.
Question mark.
Have to wear a mask while you're in school, surrounded
but
by
you can't go
people.
If you don't get
you're in a
shot.
Hallway filled with people. In the cafeteria, Susie Lou is right next to you no mask on, eating her mystery meat Monday lunch.
Or Big Daddy Pizza.
Last bite.
No. Cheers. Clink. I'm so sad.
Sorry, I needed some ketchup. It was dry.
1, 2, 3. I'm so good.
Wait, you asked me for a fry, but you still have fries.
You said you were full.
It's annoying. For people who wear a mask going into a restaurant, you're still taking your mask off. Not wearing a mask is not proving your freedom, your independence. It's not
your right.
Your rights. It's not a political statement. I mean, it's not even just people who only support Trump. It's people who don't support Trump too who are doing it. People who are just not educated. Yeah, people who are just ignorant to what's going on. I mean, it is a pandemic. People are dying. They're getting infected. They're getting sick. I mean, if we're at Publix and you're not on your 6-foot marker, I'm going to look at you.
Sorry,
through my mask. and ask you politely to please be 6 feet away.
Good person.
Even people who are traveling.
Last try.
Even people who are traveling. Like, that's so stupid. The beach is gonna always be there.
Unless you have to. Like, not work vacation. It's like, you have to.
I said the beach. I said vacation. Who has to go on vacation, Jayla? Exactly. Yeah, it's just stupid. Oh, yeah, we're going to the beach for a couple of days. We just have to get away. It's so crazy. Oh, yeah. Having to wear a mask and sit in your house is such a burden. It's so horrible. I feel so sorry for you. It's crazy. It's really crazy.
Why I got in here? Yuck. Get out!
Get out!
Ah! There's steering wheel.
Where?
No, it's up here.
Did it get out?
I don't know.
Look out your window and I'll look out mine.
It's gone.
You know, it actually feels kind of good outside.
It does.
This or Five Guys?
This. They have better buns.
Five Guys fries are better.
Five Guys have better fries and they have better buns here.
I have better buns.
You bit like a bun.
You wish you had buns.
Bye.
Okay, we're going to continue because my phone cut off.
No! It's the jacked up acrylic nails for me.
Just one hand. This one's fine. It's the not being able to pay for your own food for me.
Actually, I can't pay for my own food. I just choose not to. It's the ashy elbows for me.
Where's Bob putting lotion today? It's the hairy legs for me.
It's the hairy everything for me.
Yeah.
Didn't mean to expose you there.
It's the hairy everything for me.
You can't come
yeah,
back.
Yeah, I cook.
It's the second. It's my turn. You already said it.
Whoa.
It's the second toe a bit longer than your big toe for me.
What's the second toe being longer than your big toe? Like by 2 centimeters. Not even 2 centimeters.
Okay.
It's the wearing pink lotion on my face all day and nothing is working for me.
That one's mean. I don't wear pink lotion every day. See?
What? Wearing my shoes for me.
Yeah, well, it's too big. It's the sitting on the toilet all day for me when you're already done pooping and staying on TikTok on the toilet for 3 hours.
Disclaimer, it is very, very relaxing and helps me think. It's the not being able to write a one-page paper for me.
I've been at school for months, okay? I'm a little rusty.
So, you haven't been able to write a one-page paper all your life.
You don't have to come for me like that.
I have to help you with every paper. And it never looks anything like your original paper.
Whatever.
Ah, it's the irrational fear for flies for me. Look at you.
It's the fear of clowns for me. Actually, I don't like clowns either.
It's the fear of the dark for me.
Everyone's scared of the dark. Even if you're in a house. It's the not liking Alfredo for me. Delicious.
The fly's still in here!
Inexpensive mac and cheese. Open your window. Inexpensive mac and cheese. Okay, I don't know if it's all food.
I thought it was gonna get in my mouth.
It's the all of a sudden liking pesto for me.
You are so mad about that. It's the all of a sudden liking cheese on your breakfast sandwich at Starbucks for me. Traitor. It's the being a traitor for me.
Wow.
That's how I feel.
It makes it taste 10 times
no,
better though.
No. It's nasty. Cheese
it's
is nasty.
The
I taught you all your life from when you were coming out the womb that cheese is nasty. And you continue to go against our sister mantra. So, traitor. Traitor Joe. Traitor Joe. Traitor Joe. It's the toxic relationship that we are in.
We are in a toxic relationship.
It's the can never decide for me.
It's the planning all your meals one day ahead for me.
Meal planning is a great
thing. No, you don't make anything. You just go, Jasmine, something important. What should I have for breakfast tomorrow? Cereal or a breakfast sandwich?
So I can know, so I can look forward to when I sleep and think about it.
Oh my gosh, Jasmine, I'm so excited for tomorrow.
Why?
Because I'm making a bagel breakfast sandwich.
Because this is so freaking good.
This is what she does all the time. It's the only thinking about food for me. That's all you think about. That's all you care about is food. Your socks have food on them. You don't even eat sushi.
Yeah, but it's food.
Oh, I like food.
It's the not wanting to drive anywhere to get good food for me.
It's the not paying for gas for me.
Paying for gas?
You want me to drive everywhere? Where my gas money at?
Give me the cash. Give me the cash. Psych!
Exactly. Girl. It's the having a small, safe paper ID for me.
ID from third grade?
That she holds on to like it's a driver's license.
I have that, and then I have the one in my phone. So it's the always wearing these glasses to signature the baloney for me.
Okay, but you're wearing the same glasses and you think you're the baloney. Okay, but that's because boo boo.
Cut the cameras.
Okay, I am the baloney.
I hate baloney. Your turn.
It's the staring off into the space with a blank stare for me. Thinking about absolutely nothing for me.
It's the obsession with potato skins for me.
Girl!
What food are you even obsessed with?
I love strawberries and bananas.
Such a loser.
With strawberries and bananas? Since I was a little tyke. A tiny tyke.
Okay, your turn.
I'm running out of stuff. Still always being hungry 30 minutes after I just ate for me.
Look, hungry is hungry.
She's gonna tell me before we even make it to the house that she's hungry.
No, are you planned out that at 4 o'clock I'm gonna have one cookie, oatmeal cookie, and one
you just what? Ice cream. You said you already what? You already what it out?
Already, I don't even know.
No, you already what it out?
Look,
you already what it out? You already what it out? You already what it out?
You supposed to be dead.
You already what you out?
Supposed to be dead.
Nope, because I'm bulletproof. Nothing to lose. Okay, shoot me again. I'm waiting. No, you have to shoot me for real.
Bang!
Oh wait, I flinched.
Bang. No, nothing with my shot. Revived.
That didn't make sense.
I don't know if that was.
That didn't make sense, but it's okay because. Bang! Well, now that that's over.
Revived. Jumanji.
Anja Safa!
Okay, I'm done. That's all we have for today, folks.
It's the always trying to cut the cameras for me.
They're so very hot.